today we will do lab 4, that is on page 35 in your lab. So we will do the part of osmosis. I will demonstrate osmosis part A, and that is on page 35. So as we see on page 35, figure 4.1, we see the plasma membrane, and plasma membranes are selectively permeable. That means selectively, means they select what can go into the cell and what will go out of the cell. So osmosis, what is osmosis? Osmosis is the movement of water across a selectively permeable membrane. Now we come on page 36 in your lab. So when we come on page 36 in your lab book, please see figure 4.2. The figure 4.2 has a U-tube and it has a hypotonic solution on the left hand side and hypertonic solution on the right hand side. So we talked in the lecture what is hypotonic, what is hypertonic. Hypotonic means low concentration in relation to hypertonic. Hyper means above. So hypertonic means concentration above in relation to hypotonic. So now you see in figure 4.2, these two solutions, hypotonic and hypertonic, are separated through a selectively permeable membrane. Now see in figure 4.2, the right side U-tube. Water always moves from high water concentration towards low water concentration. So if you see in figure 4.2 on the right hand side U-tube, water has moved from hypotonic to hypertonic until the concentration on both sides is equal. So now see table 4.1 on page 36. Osmotic terms. Hypertonic means greater amount of solute and less amount of water. Hypotonic means less amount of solute and greater amount of water. Iso means same, tonic means concentration. So water concentration is equal on both sides of the membrane. So understand the concept of this. Now we come on page 37. So here you see on page 37, in the figure, you see the beaker. Beaker has 10% salt water. Inside the beaker, we have the cell that is 1% salt water. So looking at the image above, what is the percentage of water located within the cell? So percentages are out of 100. So 1% salt water means 99% water and 1% salt. What is the percentage of water located within the beaker? So now tell me, beaker has 10% salt water. So what is the percentage of water in the beaker? 10% salt means 90% water. Using the terms from table 4.1, the solution within the cell, now let's analyze it. The solution within the cell is, whether it is isotonic, hypo and hyper, what you think? Actually, less concentration of salt. So it is hypotonic. So within the cell is hypotonic, whereas the solution within the beaker is 10% salt, higher concentration. It is hypertonic. Which way will the water move? So see here on page 37, draw an arrow in the box below to summarize the movement of water between hypertonic and hypotonic. So water will move from low solute concentration to high solute concentration. It will move from hypotonic to hypertonic. So please draw an arrow on page 37. So now we come on page 38. And now I will demonstrate this technique on page 38. So it says 3 dialysis tubes, 6 rubber band, 3 200 milliliter beakers. So these are the beakers. I have already labeled them actually. And these are the beakers. And it says design 3 experimental group to demonstrate how water moves via osmosis in a variety of settings. So yeah, now you see on page 32, number 2. Beaker 1 contains a fluid that is hypotonic to the solution placed in the dialysis tube. So this is our beaker 1 and this will contain hypotonic. Now beaker 2 contains a fluid that is hypertonic. So this is our beaker 2 and that contains hypertonic. Beaker 3 contains a fluid that is isotonic. So this is beaker 3 and it contains isotonic. So now, please look at table 4.2, beaker and dialysis tube setup. So it says beaker setup. Number 1 beaker, which is this one, will have hypotonic solution. Beaker 2 has hypertonic solution and beaker 3 will have isotonic. So now we come on page 38, number 3. Place 1/4 inch of tap water. So this is our water bath and I have already put the water in it. Place the dialysis tube in the water bath. So I have soaked these dialysis tube half an hour ago into this water actually. So these dialysis tubes, I put it here so they will rehydrate. Label your beakers using the Sharpie. So I have put the tape and already labeled. Now, number 4 on page 38. While you are waiting for the dialysis tube to rehydrate, label your beakers. I have already labeled. Number 5, after several minutes, remove the dialysis tube and open the end of the dialysis tube by rolling the tube like you would open a plastic grocery bag. Caution, do not tear the tube. So these ones actually open like a Ziploc bag. So you will open them like a Ziploc bag. So like I have opened it. And I will put my finger to make sure it is not sticking and it is open actually. So see, this one rehydrated and I have opened it. Now here are the rubber bands. So what I will do, I will take a rubber band from here. And one end I need to tie. So what I do, first I move it like this. I am just moving it so it will not leak. And then I just to make sure it will not leak, I will just fold it like this here. And then I will put this one. So this one I did. So it is now. Now one end is open.
So this end is open. And now you see in your table, go on page 38, and you have table 4.3. Beaker solution is hypotonic, and the dialysis tube will have hypertonic. So number one beaker was this one, hypotonic. So I will bring the distilled water. So here is distilled water, and this distilled water is hypotonic. So I will fill this beaker. I'm taking about 100 ml water. We want to make sure that this dialysis tube will be totally submerged in it. It should be totally immersed in it. So you see figure 4.3, beaker setup hypotonic. So we have setup hypotonic. Now, we will take a dialysis tube, and this is the squirt bottle, and this is 20% sucrose. So what I will do, I will take 20% sucrose here in a squirt bottle. And in this one, actually, as it says in the directions on page 37, if you see on page 38, locate the number 7, locate the squeeze bottle containing the solution you identify. Fill the dialysis tube with 10 ml of liquid. The amount of water is not important. You can estimate 10 ml of water by filling the dialysis to the size of an average human thumb. So I will fill 20% sucrose in it now. So this is the size of the thumb actually. So now what I will do, I will rotate it like this. And then I will make it like this, and I will put, the main technique is here that it should not leak actually. So I will make sure it is not leaking. So this one. Now what I will do, I will put it on a paper towel. So now what we do, we don't squeeze or do anything. We just roll it so if there is any extra water. Now this is the balance actually. So this is the balance. I will turn the balance on and I will take the weight of it. You see on page 39, you need to write in that table 4.3 start grams. So I put it here and take the weights. So the initial weight is 42.86, and I will note it down here, 42.86. And now I will submerge it completely in the distilled water actually. So it should be completely submerged. So this is our
beaker one setup is ready. Now I will do my the second one. So I write down here 42.86. That was our start grams. Now, as it says on page 39, repeat step 6 to 10 with the remaining setup. When you have finished, place these beakers off to the side and let them sit. So for example, beaker setup 2 says hypertonic. So this one says hypertonic. Hypertonic means solution in the beaker is hypertonic. So this is 20% sucrose. I will take about 250 ml. So here I have taken 20% sucrose because this is hypertonic. Now, we will do the same thing actually. We will take another dialysis tube and repeat the steps. So see, it opens like a Ziploc bag. So main thing is opening it. And when you open it, just open gently so it will not tear it. Otherwise, it will tear it. So go slowly and slide your fingers slowly. And now I will close the one end first. So I will take a rubber band here and we need to close one end. So it is a good idea to do it like this. Okay, so this end is closed actually. And now what we will do, number two, beaker is hypertonic, dialysis tube is hypotonic. So anything below 20% will be hypotonic. It can be 1%, it can be 2%, it can be anything which is below 20% sucrose. So we can have 1% sucrose, we can have 5%, we can have 10%. Any percentage below 19 is hypertonic actually. So we are taking hypertonic solution now here.
Hypotonic
actually. So we are taking hypotonic in the dialysis bag. In the beaker we have hypertonic. Hypertonic means above, like it has a concentration above in relation to in the dialysis tube. So now see, I will tie it up and and then I put it on the paper towel to like roll it. And now I go and weigh it. So, for example, so this one is weighing
47.32. Now, this dialysis tube has hypotonic solution and it will be submerged in the beaker which has hypertonic solution. So I will submerge it in the hypertonic solution. I will put some more. So, like, so this dialysis tube is in the hypertonic. Now the last one is isotonic. So iso means same concentration. So what we will do, we will take the and it opens like a ziplock. So I will close one end first. So I twist it around and then I put this one. And we can do it like this to make sure it will not leak actually. So, and I will put one more rubber band to make sure that okay. So this one is number 3 beaker, isotonic. So you see that beaker, this beaker is isotonic. So what we will do, we will take the same concentration inside and outside. So I will just use this beaker to fill it. This beaker has a solution. Isotonic means the same concentration outside or and inside of the dialysis bag. So the inside of the dialysis bag, suppose inside of the dialysis bag we have 1% sugar solution, then outside of the bag will be 1% sugar. Inside of the bag we have distilled water. Then outside of the bag, we will also have distilled water. The concentration inside the dialysis bag and outside of the dialysis bag should be equal. Okay, then put it on the paper towel and roll it. Like you don't need to do anything, just roll it. And weigh it here. It is 48.25 and it will go in the isotonic. So this one is isotonic. And I will turn off this one so the battery will not be finished. So now I have all three setups. I want you to do one thing actually. You need to make a prediction. So you see on page 39, osmosis data. So you have taken the weight. Now make a prediction. The dialysis tube in beaker one will gain weight or lose weight. If you think gain weight, put a plus sign. If you think lose weight, put a negative sign. Now, second beaker is hypertonic. If you think the dialysis tube will lose the weight, put a negative sign. Now, the third beaker is isotonic. And in isotonic solution, if you think it will gain the weight, put plus sign. If you think it will lose the weight, put minus sign. If you think it will neither lose or gain the weight, weight will stay the same, then you can put the equal sign. The same thing you need to do actually in table 4.2, page 38. Beaker solution is hypotonic, number one. Dialysis tube solution, hypotonic. Beaker solution is hypotonic. So you have here actually distilled water. So fill this table that beaker one has distilled water. Dialysis tube has 20% sucrose. So fill that here in table 4.2. And make a prediction. What you think? If you think it will gain the weight, put a plus sign. Number two row. Hypertonic. Beaker solution is hypertonic. So beaker solution has 20% sucrose. And dialysis tube solution is, suppose it is only distilled water. Now, make a prediction, and if you think it will lose the weight, dialysis tube, put a negative sign. Isotonic, same concentration inside the dialysis and outside. So suppose we have distilled water inside the beaker and we have distilled water out in the dialysis tube, then equal sign. So fill this table actually before as like when you, once you make these, like it says here, while you are waiting for the dialysis tube to rehydrate, label your beakers using the Sharpie markers. At that time you can, or make sure you fill up this table on page 4.2. And now we will leave this setup for about an hour. And after 1 hour, we will weigh each dialysis tube again. Like we will put the dialysis tube on the paper towel, roll it, and then weigh it here again. That one will be our final grams. And then we will see final weight minus start weight. That will be net change in the grams. And then we will calculate percentage change. So I will wait for 1 hour and then we will make another video. And if you have any question, you can ask me during the lab, or you can send me your questions by email. So we will stop it here for a while. We will pause it here for a while. So now we came back after 1 hour. They were soaked into, and this beaker has hypotonic solution. So the dialysis tube has the solution which has higher concentration of solute. And the beaker has the solution which has a lower concentration of solute. We put it here and roll it here. And now we take the weight, we put it here and take the weight. So now we see in hypotonic solution, the final weight is 51.73. So we record that weight on page 39 in the table 4.3. It says final grams. And we will not need actually these dialysis tubes, so we can take out the rubber bands and the dialysis tubes can be disposed in the normal garbage bag. So now the second one is in the hypertonic. So see, this is the hypertonic, and hypertonic means the solution in the beaker is hypertonic. The solution in the beaker has higher concentration. It has 20% sucrose, whereas the solution in the dialysis bag is hypotonic, means low concentration in comparison to the beaker. So we put it here and roll it. And now we take the weight here. So we see in the hypertonic solution, the dialysis bag has lost the weight. It is 39.05. And that it was supposed to lose the weight. So now we put it here. So this was hypertonic. In hypertonic, the dialysis bag has lost the weight. Now this is the third beaker, and it says isotonic, means concentration inside the dialysis and outside the dialysis bag is the same. So we take out this one. And then we put it here. So now you see here, the weight is 48.26 gram. And as we recorded before, it was like 48.25. So only 0.01 difference can be like a drop of water stick to the dialysis bag. So our results are excellent. They are as they are supposed to be. So now what we will do, if you look at this table, we will do final gram minus start gram. So we will do here like 51.73. So 51.73 minus 42.86. And then we will calculate the percentage. For the second one, like 47.32 minus 39.05. This one will be in the negative because we will use the final weight minus the start weight. So final weight is 39.05 minus 47.32. Here it will be in the minus because lost the weight. Now final weight 42.26 and the initial weight 42.25. So only 0.01 that can be like non-significant. 0.01. So I will subtract these numbers, and then I will use this formula. Prediction column indicate the sec will gain plus for gain, lose or maintain. Net change, final weight minus start weight. So we will do from the table final minus start, the values will be here. Net change, then percentage change, we will calculate final mass minus start mass upon start mass multiplied 100. So I will do that calculation also, and I will scan this page and post it on Canvas. So you will have the data. Thanks.